and Ninja Poets with Fa, Derek Blinn, Josh Bjornberg, Victoria Guest, and Cody Shanks.
I'm sorry. Mom, I'm sorry. I'm sorry for not listening to you. I'm sorry for not saying yes. I did want to go out to breakfast that one Sunday morning. I just didn't want to get out of my bed. So you thought, but in actuality, I did. Yes, Mom, I did. Just being, you know, that 18-year-old who thought he was too old to hang out with his mom. Sorry for being that son. Always getting mad over the little things. Like, you remember last month when I accused you for throwing out my running shoes, but they were in my gym locker? Yeah, I'm sorry for that. I don't know where I'd be without you. You've helped me through from when I ran into a wall when I was a kid through my years through high school and sports. Thank you, Mom. I couldn't ask for any more. Wish I could be the son you could adore. I can't do this no more. I need to change and be with you more. I should have listened sooner, like that Saturday night when I went to go hang out with friends and you asked me to go out to dinner with you and Skip. Yeah, should have went. I'm getting older now. Time is starting to run out. Soon I'll be gone and won't be home there at night. The time is now. Now is when I should start caring more. I need to come around, be around, not worry about myself. I'll go out to those Sunday morning breakfasts with you guys and do the chores, maybe. For so long, I have made it think I didn't appreciate you. I just want to let you know that things have changed, and I'm sorry it has taken me this long to realize how much it means to me. So, you know, it's all, you know, that it will always be me and you. Mom, I love you.
That was beautiful. Scores are 8, 8, 8, 9, 9, and 9.5.
All right. I wear Speedos. I'm proud of my manhood, just like any man should. There's no need to be ashamed, for Speedos are never lame. They may cause a little pain, but it's what we use to train. Swimming is only a woman's sport? Psh, that's a joke. Think about it. They even made something called the breaststroke. So while kids are out partying with kegs, I am in the bathroom shaving my legs. So I rock that smooth swag. No hair to be found. Baby bottoms, arms, my skin will astound. Some people wear an oversuit because they're scared to show it, but I stand legs open proud. Yeah, you know it. I was once like you, my insecurities so high. Scared to be anything but the average guy. Hidden behind my mask, afraid of who would stare. Until one day I realized I just don't care. So I took off my mask and I started macking. It was immaculate at how I seemed so masculine. I was attacking like an assassin and I stayed on task until I got shut down colder than an Alaskan. But I took it out on the pool, cause real men don't cry. Besides when you're doing the butterfly. How ironic, such pure insects, but in the pool it's killing your shoulders and pecs. Well, we can take a back like backstroke, and there's ain't no joke, there's very few things that I can hope. Or even the freestyle my style, I can do whatever I want or that my brain can compile. Cause when I'm in the water, I live with no regrets. The race is on, so let's take some bets. And when I get to the top, I'll say that I made it. And for all of you wondering, no, we don't shower naked. We could have worn jammers or Speedos, it was my call. But I obviously chose Speedos because I actually have guts. You don't know swimming until you've been to a meet, watch a close last race and feel the intensity. Water running through my hair, keeping the natural swirl. So yeah, I wear a Speedo, but I still bring home girls.
Judges' scores are 9, 9, 9, 9.5, 9, and 9.5.
You see, being annoying isn't something someone can be when they want. It's something you are all the time. You see, annoying is when someone won't shut up and they keep talking, but really no one's listening. That's when they know they're annoying. You see, annoying is when you can distract that teacher of yours for a really long time and you get like 4 or 5 other students just to keep raising their hand. Yeah, that's annoying. You see, it's annoying when someone in the poetry slam reads a poem about being annoying, and every time they start a new line, they say, "You see?" You see, it's annoying. You see, it's annoying when you get a friend request on Facebook and you're like, "Yes, another friend that added my like 1,000 something friends," and it's your mom. And like, you and your 3 brothers are her only 4 friends. That's annoying. You see, annoying is when you're trying to study or do homework and your brother is in the other room blasting his music and there's absolutely positively nothing you can possibly do because he is bigger and stronger than you, so you have to do the best to block out the sound. That's annoying. You see, it's annoying when someone in the poetry slam stands up here and reads a poem about wearing Speedos. Or being good at swimming. But in reality, they are really good. You see, that's annoying. Am I being annoying?
The judges' scores are 9, 9, 9, 9.5, 9.5, and 10.
Yeah, buddy. My parents always ask me, what am I going to do with my life? And I really don't have an answer to them because I don't know. Some fear the unknown, but I don't. I embrace it. Not knowing what's going to happen next week, next month, or 5 minutes from now, I try to live a life where I can be free from conformity, normality, and reality, bathe in the unknown waterfalls of imagination, bask in the glories of free souls. But it's kind of hard when you battle the constant struggle to impress my parents, to live to their expectations. I'm shackled to a room where the windows and doors are barred with rules and the idea of control. Every day I allow myself to feel and taste and mingle with those who I envy. I envy you, my fellow classmates, my peers, my friends. Every day, The flow of jealousy runs rapidly in my veins as I watch my friends talk about their nights before and the nights to come. I watch as they reflect on past memories of burning fires and dinner dates. I'm left behind to sulk in my regrets. I'm left tarnished and broken, like the little boy who can't find his mother at the grocery store. He zigzags through pillars of clothing, making his way to the food aisles where the walls feel like they're closing in, suffocating, and then he stops. Looks left and then right, and it's at that moment he realizes he's alone. He's lost all hope of being found. And that's when those dreaded tears begin to fall. People scurry down the aisles, not giving a damn about the crying boy, thinking more about their grocery list than the list of problems streaming down the boy's face. I am the little boy, and my words are those tears, but I am proud to say I'm as free as the birds because I'm able to stand here and recite these words. Tell you the story of my life and my constant battle with strife. I am now able to let the little boy go and show others how to grow from a point so low where all you hear is the voice of a dreadful crow to a point so high where you can take it slow and just go with the flow. But I'm in so much pain because my brain is going insane. I'm done caring what others think, driving me to my brink. I'm tired of all this vanity, the wretched cruelty of inhumanity. For so long, I've buried these words deep within my soul, but today, I've allowed these words to seize control.
Judges' scores are 9, 9, 8.5, 9, 9, and